Black suit, baby, in action in the movie. Because, of course, Zack Snyder has already famously shared a photo of this on his Vero account, but today we got to see it in action. It was a teeny tiny clip, which he said it would be in my interview with him on Monday. He delivered, and he doesn't need to be a large clip because we see the black suit in action. Oh, it's fantastic. For those of you who are like, I wanted more, well, there's a little thing called DC FanDome coming up on August 22nd, and oh, you're going to get more. And it makes sense that, of course, we'd be at that official event, so mark your calendars for that. So here he is in the black and silver, more silver than I would have expected, but we're going to talk about that. There's a lot of, he gave a little couple of bits of information about the black suit, and also working with Warner Brothers. Oh, fascinating. But anyway, yes, again, as I said, he teased on Monday that he would be sharing a teeny tiny clip at Justice Con, which has been going on all day today, on its own channel here on YouTube. I put a link down below in the video description if you want to go check that out. And they have programming tomorrow as well. And not only that, but there was a really cool, the other thing, you know, he teased two things in my interview. He said he was going to do a clip and a little announcement for the fans. And the announcement was that there's a cool t-shirt that they're giving, well, you purchase it and the money goes to charity. And it's a really cool fan t-shirt where you get to write your name on the back for under where it says associate producer. It's a really nice piece of, you know, memorabilia for Zack Snyder's Justice League. So go over to the panel, not only to watch that interview, but to find out how you can get that and to see the clip. It's so short and, you know, it's there. I think it's an exclusive to them. So if you want to actually see the clip, you can see it over there on that panel. But I have screen grabs here. And just basically to walk you through it, you know, you have the cool Jurassic Park shout out where Alfred's drink is vibrating as Superman approaches. Then he lands and he's like, where's Bruce Wayne? And Alfred's like, hey, what's up, man? So that's the clip, basically. But you get a really good look at the suit. That's the purpose of this clip, seeing the black suit. The black suit is so important to Justice League. And the big thing that he revealed to me that's even bigger than seeing the black suit in action is that Warner Brothers did not understand that. So what did he say? So Zack said, hey, guess what? This scene isn't color corrected because it looks surprisingly bright for a Zack Snyder movie. So he's like, it's not color corrected. And the reason it's not color corrected yet is that we intentionally shot it brighter than we wanted it to be because Warner Brothers didn't want to do a black suit. What? So he said Warner Brothers didn't want to do a black suit. So the plan was always to kind of do this halfway thing where like, it's still bright and cheery, even though it's black. He's like Disney Channel goth, basically, in the way that's color corrected right now. It's like Disney Channel's like, we have a goth kid, what are you talking about? Although, ironically, Disney is doing the most comics accurate stuff right now. But anyway, it's frustratingly true. But anyway, the plan was always to color correct it in post to be more what Zack Snyder wants. And by the way, his visuals are always incredibly strong, so I can't wait to see what he's going to do to this image in post. It's very cool. Because, you know, first they have to do all the visual effects, and then they can start doing the color correcting and stuff like that. And, you know, there's a lot to render in this movie, because, you know, there's characters that are, you know, I saw a little bit of what they're going to, he showed me what they're going to do at a show at DC FanDome. Is long, and it's like, when I saw it, it was like not and all rendered. So there's a lot of rendering to do in the next month. But yeah, so anyway, he has to totally change this in post. So this was kind of like the happy medium. Warner Brothers executives were like, okay, you can put him in black as long as the rest of the movie is really bright and cheery. And he's like, okay, films it that way. Because, you know, when you film a movie, you might not know this, you have to send your dailies to the executives. So the executives get copies of the footage that's being shot every day so they can keep an eye on how the movie's progressing without actually having to be on set. They're called dailies. So the dailies look nice, bright, happy, and cheery, and then the plan all along when he got to post was to Snyder it up. So I'm very excited to see that. But again, Warner Brothers' problem continues to be that there are no executives working on these DC movies that know the comics, even at the very least know the comics, and obviously don't love the comics. Because anyone would tell you, even the most casual DC fan would tell you, he's got to be in the black suit. We were all looking forward to the black suit. It was all about the black suit and the buildup to the movie when it was first going to come out. And I think even, you would think that even when someone pointed out to a Warner Brothers executive, said, well, you know what? You might be against the black suit, but let me explain to you how in the comics, when Superman resurrected from the dead, he was wearing the black suit, and as part of its canon, then you would think an executive would go, okay, well, then I guess we should do it. But they were apparently like, no, we still don't think we need to do it. He should be back in the red and blue. It makes absolutely no sense to me. So that's shocking. Just absolutely shocking to me. I mean, the whole movie is about the resurrection. By the way, the reason it's a black suit is it's supposed to be a Kryptonian healing suit, which is why in the comics it looks a little bit different than his suit. Instead of, you know, it has no cape and it looks a little bit more like, you know, it's a little bit more of a brawler look than a regal look. You know, it really changed the way, you know, it was supposed to be a new look for Superman. So it's a little bit, it's interesting that here in this movie, it would just be a black and silver version of his original costume. But when you now know that it was a fight to even get that, there's no way you'd convince Warner Brothers to let you lose the cape, right? But it's supposed to look very different than his usual suit because it's a Kryptonian healing suit. Now, I've told you before the importance of visual cues as to what movie you're looking at, particularly in a franchise. So not only is it important for the comic book, you know, the canon for the stories that everybody wants to see brought to life in live action, but it's important to distinguish Justice League from other Superman adventures, other Superman movies. So it really needs to be that Justice League is the black suit Superman movie. So I don't understand how Warner Brothers didn't even get that. I mean, I would have liked to have, in an ideal world, I would have liked to have lost the cape, grown out the hair a little bit, and given him even, I would have gone even further. I like the 5 o'clock shadow that some fan art put on Henry Cavill. We all know how good he looks with some facial hair. And instead, you know, well, we don't even want to talk about the other version. But, you know, Henry Cavill and facial hair have an interesting relationship at this point. It's done both wonders and horrors for him. But that's, I think, ideally what we would have liked. But again, you know, I think Zack Snyder got as much as he could out of Warner Brothers, and it seems like, you know, from what he's saying, that was quite a fight in and of itself. All right, so let's talk about, and it's fascinating to look behind the scenes. You know, we've talked about all the stuff's gone on with Geoff Johns, and now there's other stuff that's a struggle. It's really, you can see that it's really difficult over there to make these movies, and it shouldn't be. It's frustrating. For us, imagine how frustrating it is for people like Zach, who's actually the one doing it and has their name on it. So I'm glad he's getting this chance to do what's right. So let's talk about this clip. First off, he doesn't do the superhero landing. He lowers himself down into the back garage, where Alfred is working on Bruce Wayne's car, one of the more incognito Batmobiles, right? And I like, as I said, the cool Jurassic Park nod with Alfred's drink vibrating as Superman enters the area. And I like this because it juxtaposes like the pure power of Superman, that like the sonic boom of maybe him entering the atmosphere, or, you know, whatever would cause the drink to do that. That just shows how powerful he is. But the fact that he doesn't do a superhero landing, but that he's able to just lower himself in, but very quickly, just shows that he has not only power, but precision. I love it. That's one of my favorite things. I talked to Zach about that in my interview with him on Monday. I love how powerful his Superman is. Love it. Love to see it. And you see it even in a brief clip like this. Now, again, as I said, more silver than I would have expected, but this is the non-color corrected version. I think it could look quite different when Zach's done with it. Also, Zach is working on a black and white version of the film. That's all I can tell you right now. He has said that he's, you know, he likes the black and white look. The posters for it are black and white. And I do know that there will be a black and white version at some point. Let's just say that for now. And I think the suit will look really good in black and white. And I think it fits Justice League, not only from an artistic perspective for Zach to show his film in black and white, but again, it picks up on the theme of the black and silver in this case, but basically black and white suit for Superman. So to have the whole film in black and white, I think is a thing of beauty. It's a really strong idea. The original suit, as you can see, had even more silver, had a lot of bling to it, and even these weird silver boots and like some points silver toes, I don't like that at all. I like here that it's a more sleeker, elongated look, and it seems to be all black for the whole bottom half. I think that's great. So again, I think that, you know, the cape, I would have preferred not to have the cape, but I do like Zack Snyder's cape. I like the way that it's a visual effect and it moves so beautifully. I think that's fantastic. And I am excited to see more with this suit. But again, I think that this is, you know, you can just see the struggle that Zach has had to deal with Warner Brothers. Just really, you know, instead of the studio, well, you know what, let's not get into it too much because they're letting him do what he wants now. And I think that's really important. I'm very excited to see this. So to reiterate, thrilled to see the black suit. I continue to love the raw power of Zack Snyder's Superman. Again, power and precision. What a combo. Add some laser vision and I'm going to be in heaven. Disappointed in Warner Brothers' position regarding the suit, but it just shows more of what's going on over there behind the scenes. And I'm very interested in this color correction. I can't wait to see how the film looks that way. I mean, again, I just think Zack Snyder's visuals are probably the strongest in the business. I love them. They were one of the things I wanted the most out of. If you might recall from my top list of things I want in the Snyder Cut, one was those sweet, sweet Zack Snyder visuals. And it looks like I'm going to get them. So what do you think? Share your thoughts down below. And again, of course, if you're itching for more, don't worry. I mean, he said it was longer than 214 minutes in my interview with him. Then today, he said that it was around, he was talking more, you know, it was... he let it slip that it was 4 hours, and I can tell you that he told me that as well. So it's 4 hours, and I know how it's going to be unveiled on HBO Max and some of the plans for after that, and I just think you're going to be absolutely thrilled. Hopefully we'll get those details at DC FanDome. So mark your calendar. All right, so share your thoughts down below. Thanks for going over this with me. Subscribe today, and of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.